Welcome back, family. It's your boy Buddha. We're gonna get right into it. So look, remember when Young Thug's sister said it was gonna be some good news, or they had some good news, or some good news was coming, or whatever she was talking about, and we kept saying after she said it was gonna be some good news, it's been bad news ever since then. Yeah, been bad news ever since then. You know what I'm saying? So what happened is she say Young Thug supposed to have a bond because they had him locked up past the time, and he wasn't supposed to be held that long without a bond, and they were supposed to gave him a bond. So she thought he was gonna get a bond and that he was coming home. This is why people were saying that he was coming home. Now I don't know if the lawyers told her that, I don't know if the judge told her that, whoever told her that, but yeah, Young Thug was supposed to get a bun. Now, I ain't never think they was gonna get him no bun after you had Kevin Lyles in there and all that stuff he said he'll put up and do this and do that. When they turned that down, I said, oh, I knew right then and there, like, nah, they ain't gonna let him out. Then you gotta take into account that you got too many people in YSL snitching. You got too many people telling. Yeah, so he gonna have to fight it, man. He just gotta fight the case. So we gonna go on here and listen to his sister. I'm gonna let y'all hear what she got to say about the whole situation.
But that shit was all on the blogs and all that, but that still is not evidence of him harassing someone, of him doing nothing. They don't have nothing of him. Technically, that judge supposed to give my brother a bond. Technically. His 90 days, he been in there 90 days. You cannot not give a person a bond three times, and when they go to court and you deny they bond three times and they've been 90 days, technically you cannot do that, and you don't have no type of evidence, like nothing. You just going by whatever they said, whatever that shit was all on the blogs and all that, but that still is not evidence of him harassing someone, of him doing nothing. They don't have nothing of him. Technically, that judge supposed to.
All right, now look, check this out. One thing she said I don't agree with, they going by stuff they read on the blogs. No, no, Dolly, I can't give you that one, baby. Now, you know, Booty, you know, we fell for you when you said the money was gone, you know what I'm saying? But they ain't got nothing on them. Dolly, you know them dudes telling that. You said it yourself. They telling, they ain't riding, they snitching. You know what I'm saying? So you already know they got something on them. That you said they ain't got nothing on them. Hold on, we ain't gonna go that far. Now you know what I'm saying? Now you might be seeing stuff in the blogs and all, man, the courts and all them people, man. They don't look at stuff like that, cause guess what? If they look at something like that and try to roll with something like that, any flaw within that could hurt their case. They don't want nothing that's gonna hurt the case. Everything they getting, everything they standing on, they needed to be a part of the case to slam him and the other YSL members. So they ain't finna come out here like, they ain't gonna walk in there like, yeah, we was on the shade room, and on the shade room, they said, Thug and Gutta been threatening people. No, they ain't gonna do that. Now, what they did do pertaining to they snitches, they did go on different sites for the comment section where people were saying that, like Lil Woody, family and his kids in danger and this and that. But see, that was Fanny them folks. You talking about she don't know how the information got leaked. I guess she trying to work her system and she don't know how the other systems work. You got to get it to Fanny. Get her, Fanny. We already told you, Fanny. There's a whole lot of information that probably shouldn't be getting out. How all y'all snitches information getting leaked? Now they're here. It ain't stopping. Well, it's a new YSL snitch every day. Every day. Immediately too. Like, they like, yeah, it was me. Yeah, hey. Like, hey, put me in PC. They probably been shaking up with him and everything. Slit, slash, slimy. We slimy. We snakes. We this, we that. We gonna get back on the streets. Whole time these the ones that's telling. Whole time these the ones with the tap cell phone. Whole time these the ones been building and building and building and building. So like I told y'all before, that's what's gonna be the problem. Young Thug lawyer, Not Gunna, because I ain't nobody told nothing on Gunna. Like, ain't nobody told nothing on Gunna yet. As far as I know, I haven't seen it. But as far as Young Thug go, his lawyer got to go in there. Bruh, just think about it. If you a lawyer and you had to defend against every account each one of these individuals is saying, bruh, it's not like one thing. Okay, this individual know about a murder. This individual know about a shoot. This individual was present for a murder. This individual was present for the shooting. This individual this. This individual that. Imagine your lawyer got to defend against all that. So y'all got to think, bro, it ain't like in this case, it's just finna be one person saying, yeah, he did this. Yeah, he did that. No. And they protecting their witnesses. So yeah, when they leave PC, they going straight to court. They got to testify against this man. And that's what's going to happen, people. And that's going to be the hardest part about his case. But y'all get in the comment section, man. Let me know what y'all think. Should Young Thug done had a bun by now? Or it's just unbeatable with all the telling you got going on with YSL, man? It's your boy Buddha. I'm out.